good.
Did you talk to Mary? I haven't talked to her that I was worried about because she wasn't, she didn't come to church yesterday morning and she didn't come Thursday. I got to call if she's not here this morning.
Let my prayer come into your presence. Incline your ear to my cry for help, O Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Oh, brothers and sisters, welcome as we prepare to celebrate the Holy Mass. And we're offering the Mass this morning for the intention of Joseph Dawn and all souls. So let us prepare ourselves. We call to mind our sins and we ask the Lord's pardon. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Well, I think we'll need a reader today.
No, she don't do none.
Okay. Sister?
Just one
reader.
Yeah.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Love justice, you who judge the earth. Think of the Lord in goodness and seek him in integrity of heart. Because he is found by those who test him love, and he manifests himself to those who do not disbelieve him. For perverse counsel separate a man from God, and his power, put to the proof, rebukes the foolhardy. Because into a soul that plans evil, wisdom enters not, nor dwells she in a body under death of sin. For the Holy Spirit of discipline flees the sick, and withdraws from senseless counsels. And when injustice occurs, it is rebuked. For wisdom is a kindly spirit, yet she acquits not the blasphemer of his guilty lips, because God is the witness of his inmost self, and the sure observer of his heart, and the listener of his tongue. For the Spirit of the Lord fills the world, is all-embracing, and knows what man says. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way.
Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way.
O Lord, you have called me, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I stand. You understand my thoughts from afar. My journeys and my rest you scrutinize. With all my ways, you are familiar.
Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way.
Even before a word is on my tongue, behold, O Lord, you know the whole of it. Behind me and before, you hem me in the rest of your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too lofty for me to attain. Where can I go from your spirit, from your presence, where can I flee? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I sink to the nether world, you are present there. If I take the wings of the dawn, if I settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall guide me, and your right hand holds me fast.
Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way.
Shine like lights in the world as you hold on to the word of life.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Things that cause sin will inevitably occur, but woe to the one through whom they occur. It would be better for him if a millstone were put around his neck and he'd be thrown into the sea, than for him to cause one of these little ones to sin. Be on your guard. If your brother sins, rebuke him, and if he repents, forgive him. And if he wrongs you 7 times in 1 day and returns to you 7 times saying, 'I'm sorry,' then you should forgive him." And the apostle said to the Lord, "Increase our faith." The Lord replied, "If you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you would say to this mulberry tree, 'Be uprooted and planted in the sea,' and it would obey you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
I was reading the psalm several times today, and it suddenly occurred to me, you know, this is Psalm 139, and we're more familiar with the psalm, the 23rd psalm, which is the good shepherd, you know, that is walking along beside us with his rod and his staff to protect us, especially when we're going into the valley of darkness and death. So that's a great psalm there, but I think the Lord is saying that in this psalm, too, in a little different way. Because the good shepherd, we always want the good shepherd around. Now, whether we want to listen to him, that's another factor. But we like him around when it's getting dangerous. So here, just think about this now in this psalm, which is the 139th psalm. First of all, it says, "Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way." That's the way to heaven. He says, "Lord, you probe me and you know me. You know when I sit and when I stand. You understand my thoughts from afar. With all my ways you are familiar." Well, isn't that another way of saying the Good Shepherd is with us all the time? He knows everything that's going on in us, in each one of us here. And all the 7 billion people throughout the world, he knows what's going on in our mind, what illnesses we have, what challenges we are facing, what good things he's got planned for us. God knows all that. And we are sent as God's servants into this world to do what he wants us to do. So it's a good idea to keep our ears open so that the Lord can talk to us. And when we recognize that we're going into a challenge or a dangerous time, it's not that we're going into that alone. We're going into that with the Lord. And if we think about it, we should ask for help, because he's certainly the source of infinite help for us. So then he reminds us in the gospel today about a couple of things that are certain. He says, things that cause sin will inevitably occur, but don't be the cause of the sin for somebody else. In other words, be careful of your conduct. Pay attention to your conduct. And I'm talking to myself too. Pay attention to our conduct as we're going through the day with the challenges and the graces that pour out upon us. Pay attention to our conduct, because we want our conduct to be helpful to people, not hurtful. And he says, be careful if you, in effect, he says, be better if this person is the cause of sin, that somebody else would be a millstone placed around his neck and thrown in the sea. Because the Lord is careful and protective of the little ones, he says. Well, the little ones doesn't mean just only little kids. That's certainly important. We want to give a good example to the kids. But there's people that are weak in their faith and are struggling in their faith, and they need our example too. So that's another reason to be paying attention as we're going through the day, how we're living that day, how we're handling the challenges. And of course, if we get sinned against 7 times a day, and the person
person's driving us nuts with his sin, he says, be ready to forgive him. Because when we sin, and we recognize it during the day, we might ask God for forgiveness. And how many times during the day would we ask God for that? And God doesn't have a problem forgiving us. He wants to forgive us. So that we are prepared and strengthened as we go along the everlasting way to get to the place where he wants us to go. Where is that? Where are we headed for? Silence. Heaven. We're headed for heaven. That's God's plan for every one of us. So we need to be paying attention and asking for this help that he's always by our side, willing to offer if we just open up and recognize. We're not doing this alone. We've got the Lord with us. We've got our guardian angel with us. So let's take advantage of those opportunities that we have to get help. Call on the Lord, whatever we need.
Let's bring our prayers and petitions before the Lord today. I pray for the church, especially the church here in Baton Rouge and under our Bishop Michael, that she will be given the graces that she needs to spread the word, to share the truth of Jesus Christ with all those people, especially here in this parish, who don't have an idea about Jesus Christ. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Thanksgiving coming up and for some of the meals that we've got planned. Police Chief of Baker is going to provide transportation for some of the people coming here for meals. That the goodwill of that police chief here and the goodwill of other folks to cook them. See Bell here cooking meals also. So all these people that are trying to help others who are in need, we pray to the
Lord.
For what else should we pray today?
For the protection of the unborn, we pray to the Lord.
Responded in the name of Jesus, who is you and the Holy Spirit, is one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. We pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gift offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy,
Holy, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis our Pope and Michael our Bishop, and all those who hold him to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, that they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering of every sacrifice. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in the faith, the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants, the poor souls in purgatory who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Bless also your servants, you little sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, to whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
For at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
We offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me. Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Father.